Dear students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Professor P. Bhaskar Reddy, Department of Ancient Indian History, Culture and Archaeology, Sri Venkateswara University, Tirupati, the principal coordinator of the subject Indian Culture and also course coordinator for the paper Outlines of Indian History. In this module, you are going to learn about the history of the Cholas. The learning objectives of the module are introduction, which deals about the origin of the Chola dynasty, then foundation of the imperial Cholas, features of the Chola polity, socio-economic life of the period, the temple art, architecture and painting. With this objectives, let us start to know about the origin of the Chola dynasty. The Cholas played an important role in the political and cultural history of South India in particular and India in general. The core region of their control was Chola Mandalam, located in the Tamil Nadu state of India. The standards established in society, religion and fine arts were regarded as classical. They took active intervention in political, commercial and cultural expansion in Southeast Asia. Regarding the origin of the Cholas, early references to the Cholas found in the rock edicts of Ashoka along with other dynasties Cheras and Pandyas. Among the Cholas of early age, Karikala Chola was the greatest early Chola king, who is credited with the foundation of the city of Puhar. Later on, the Cholas lost their political importance. The post-Sangam history is unclear. After the decline of Sangama age, the Cholas became feudatories in Oraiyur region. In the beginnings of the 9th century, once again they regained their political power and expanded their empire over a major portion of South India. Vijayalaya was the founder of this dynasty. During his time, he accepted the overleadership of Pallavas and began his rule. He captured Thanjavur from the Muttarayar chiefs and made Thanjavur as his capital. Thus, the Cholas became popular as Thanjavuru Cholas. Aditya the First was the another king. He also achieved significant military success and expanded the Chola kingdom in early stage. He defeated the Pallava overlord Aparajita Varma and occupied entire Thondamandalam from them. He also conquered Kongu Desha from the Pandyas and captured Talakad, the capital of the Western Gangas. Thus, during the time of Vijayalaya and Aditya, they established the Chola power in Thanjavur with independent status. The next ruler, Parantaka the First, he is considered as the real founder of the Chola Empire. During his time, he campaigned against the Pandyas and captured their capital Madura. To commemorate this event, he assumed the title Madurai Konda, that is conqueror of Madurai. The Pandyan ruler who suffered defeat under Parantaka sought the help of the Sri Lankan king. Parantaka later also defeated the combined army at the battle of Velluru, but Parantaka suffered in the battle of Takkolam under Rashtrakuta king Krishnadithat. Parantaka was a great builder of temples. During his time, he provided golden roof to the Vimana of Chidambaram temple. The Parantaka, the first train is very important to study the local self-government of the age, because the Uttar Meru inscriptions were issued by him. They record in detail the village administration under the Cholas. After the death of Parantaka the first, for nearly 30 years the Cholas suffered setback, and this period is considered as dark period. The Chola power was reached peak during the reign of Arumoli Varman, who assumed the title Rajaraja the first. He laid the foundation of a mighty empire with his conquests and invasions. He provided excellent administrative setup for the Chola Empire. Regarding the achievements of Rajaraja the first, he destroyed the navy of Cheras at Trivandrum. He defeated the Pandyan king Amarabhujanga and later imprisoned him and annexed the entire Pandyan territory into the Chola Empire. He also conducted successful naval expedition to the Sri Lanka region, which it led to the destruction of Anuradhapura. As a result, the Chola province was established under the name of Mummadi Chola Mandalam in the northern part of Sri Lanka. He also scored victories against the Western Gangas, Chalukyas and Rashtrakutas, and maintained matrimonial alliance with the Eastern Chalukyas of Vengi. In the later course of his time, he also conducted the naval expedition against the Maldive Islands. As a result, Maldives also formed part of the Chola Empire. He encouraged Sri Mara Vijayottunga Varman, the Shailendra ruler of Southeast Asia. He assumed the titles Mummadi Chola, Jayakonda and Sivapada Sekara. He was a great administrator and builder. As a builder, he built the famous Brihadeshwara temple at Thanjavuru in 1010 Christian era. He was a devout follower of Shaivism and also patronized a Buddhistic monastery at Nagapatnam. See the grandeur of the Brihadeshwara temple built by Rajaraja the Great. Rajendra the First was another important ruler of the Chola dynasty, who ruled in between 1014 to 1044. He also continued the policy of expansion. He completed the conquest of Ceylon by defeating and imprisoning the Sri Lanka ruler Mahendra the Fifth. He reasserted the Chola supremacy over the kings of Kerala and also the Pandyan country, who tried to assert their independence. He defeated the Western Chalukyas, who were trying to meddle in the succession dispute of Vengi. Thus, he successfully re-established and expanded the Chola territories over a major portion of South India. The famous expedition of the Rajendra the First is his invasion over Northern India. In this invasion, he successfully defeated the Pala king Mahipala. It is said to be that after scoring a victory, he brought the waters of Ganga to Chola Empire. He also conducted naval expedition against the king of Sri Vijaya in Southeast Asia, where he also scored victory in that enterprise. He was the responsible person who founded న్యూ క్యాపిటల్ అట్ గంగైకొండ చోళపురం అండ్ అజ్యూమ్డ్ ద టైటిల్ గంగైకొండ. సో ఫార్ వి డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ ది అచీవ్మెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ టూ గ్రేట్ రూలర్స్ రాజరాజ ది ఫస్ట్ అండ్ రాజేంద్ర ది ఫస్ట్ డ్యూరింగ్ దేర్ టెన్యూర్ త్రూ దేర్ ఇన్వేషన్స్ ది చోళ టెరిటోరియల్ లిమిట్స్ నాట్ ఓన్లీ కన్ఫైన్ టు సౌత్ ఇండియా అండ్ ఈవెన్ దే వర్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ ఫర్ ది ఎక్స్పాన్షన్ ఆఫ్ ద చోళ పవర్ ఇన్ శ్రీలంక మాల్దీవ్ ఐలాండ్స్ అండ్ ఆల్సో శైలేంద్ర ఎంపైర్ దస్ దే ఆర్ కన్సిడర్డ్ యాజ్ ద గ్రేటెస్ట్ రూలర్స్ ఆఫ్ ది చోళ ఎంపైర్ నౌ వీ కెన్ షిఫ్ట్ అవర్ డిస్కషన్ ది అదర్ రూలర్స్ ఆఫ్టర్ రాజేంద్ర ది ఫస్ట్ రాజాది రాజా ది ఫస్ట్ వాజ్ ద అనదర్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ కింగ్ డ్యూరింగ్ ది రెయిన్ ఆఫ్ రాజరాజ ది ఫస్ట్ ది అథారిటీ ఆఫ్ ద చోళాస్ వాజ్ డిఫీట్ బై ద పాండ్యాస్ చేరాస్ అండ్ ది కింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ సిలోన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ సెట్ టు బి దట్ హీ సప్రెస్డ్ ఆల్ ద రివాల్స్ అండ్ వన్స్ అగైన్ చోళా పవర్ ఫిర్మ్లీ ఎస్టాబ్లిష్డ్ ఇన్ దేర్ టెరిటరీస్ టు కమమరేట్ దీస్ విక్టరీస్ హీ పర్ఫార్మ్డ్ అశ్వమేధ సాక్రిఫైస్ డ్యూరింగ్ ది టైమ్ ఆఫ్ రాజరాజ ది ఫస్ట్ హీ రివైవ్డ్ ద కాన్ఫ్లిక్ట్ విత్ ద వెస్టర్న్ చాళుక్యాస్ వన్స్ అగైన్ బట్ హీ లాస్ట్ వేంగి అండ్ కళింగ టు ద వెస్టర్న్ చాళుక్యాస్ ఇన్ ద బ్యాటిల్స్ విత్ వెస్టర్న్ చాళుక్యాస్ హీ లాస్ట్ హిస్ లైఫ్ ఇన్ ద బ్యాటిల్ ఆఫ్ కొప్పారం ఇన్ ద వేంగి కంట్రీ దస్ రాజరాజాది ఫస్ట్ రెయిన్ కేమ్ టు నైన్ ఆఫ్టర్ ది డెత్ ఆఫ్ రాజరాజాది ఫస్ట్ ద మిలిటరీ కాన్ఫ్లిక్ట్స్ కంటిన్యూడ్ అండ్ మార్క్డ్ ది రెయిన్స్ ఆఫ్ సబ్సిక్వెంట్ చోళా కింగ్స్ ది రాజరాజేంద్ర ది సెకండ్ వీరరాజేంద్ర అండ్ ఆదిరాజేంద్ర హూ ఫాలోడ్ అప్ టు 1070 AD బట్ ద చోళా పవర్ స్టార్టెడ్ టు డిక్లైన్ ది చోళా పవర్ వన్స్ అగైన్ రీగెయిన్డ్ అండర్ ది కులోత్తుంగ ది ఫస్ట్ దిస్ కులోత్తుంగ ది ఫస్ట్ వాజ్ ది గ్రాండ్ సన్ ఆఫ్ రాజేంద్ర ది ఫస్ట్ అండ్ సన్ ఆఫ్ ఈస్టర్న్ చాళుక్యన్ కింగ్ రాజరాజ నరేంద్ర హీ వాజ్ ద రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ పర్సన్ హూ యునైటెడ్ ద టూ కింగ్డమ్స్ ఆఫ్ చాళుక్యాస్ ఆఫ్ వెంగి అండ్ ది చోళాస్ ఆఫ్ తంజావూర్ దస్ హీ బికేమ్ ద ఫౌండర్ ఆఫ్ ఏ న్యూ లైన్ ఆఫ్ డైనాస్టీ దట్ ఈస్ చాళుక్య చోళ డైనాస్టీ డ్యూరింగ్ హిస్ టైమ్ విజయబాహు ది కింగ్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీలంక బికేమ్ ఇండిపెండెంట్ అండ్ హీ లాస్ట్ వేంగి అండ్ మైసూర్ టు ది వెస్టర్న్ చాళుక్యాస్ ద ఓల్డ్ ఎనిమీస్ ఆఫ్ ద ఫార్ సౌత్ పాండ్యాస్ చేరాస్ వర్ రిమైన్డ్ హోస్టైల్ బట్ హిస్ పీరియడ్ ఈజ్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఇన్ ది ఎకనామిక్ హిస్టరీ ఆఫ్ సౌత్ ఇండియా దేర్ వాజ్ ఎ స్టడీ ఇంప్రూవ్మెంట్ ఇన్ కామర్స్ అండ్ హీ మెయింటైన్డ్ బెటర్ కమ్యూనికేషన్ విత్ ద చైనీస్ హీ సెంట్ ఎన్ ఎంబసీ ఆఫ్ 72 మర్చెంట్స్ టు చైనా ఇన్ ద ఇయర్ 1077 హీ మెయింటైన్డ్ కార్డియల్ రిలేషన్స్ విత్ శ్రీ విజయ అండ్ హీ రిసీవ్డ్ ఎన్ ఎంబసీ వెల్ ఫ్రమ్ హిమ్ డ్యూ టు హిస్ పాలసీ ఆఫ్ టాక్సేషన్ హీ అజ్యూమ్డ్ ద టైటిల్ సుంగం తవిర్త కులోత్తుంగ ది ఫస్ట్ వాజ్ సక్సీడెడ్ బై హిస్ సన్ విక్రమ చోళ సర్నేముడు త్యాగసముద్ర ఫాలోడ్ బై కులోత్తుంగ ది సెకండ్ రాజరాజాది సెకండ్ రాజాది రాజాది సెకండ్ అండ్ కులోత్తుంగ ది థర్డ్ డ్యూరింగ్ దేర్ రూల్ ద ఇంపీరియల్ పవర్ ఆఫ్ ద చోళాస్ డిక్లైన్డ్ రాజేంద్ర ది థర్డ్ వాజ్ ద లాస్ట్ రూలర్ హూ సఫర్డ్ డిఫీట్ అండర్ జాతవర్మ సుందర పాండ్య ది కాకతీయాస్ అండ్ హోయసాలాస్ హూ రోస్ టు ప్రామినెన్స్ ఇన్ డెక్కన్ అండ్ సౌత్ ఇండియా దే పార్టిషన్డ్ అమంగ్ దెమ్సెల్వ్స్ ద టెరిటరీ ఆఫ్ ది చోళా ఎంపైర్ Thus, the Chola power lost in the beginnings of 13th century. So far, we discussed about the political history of the Cholas, who rose to prominence in the beginnings of 9th century AD and dominated the destinies of South India up to the beginning of 13th century AD. This period is important in the political history of South India, but also more important in the cultural history, because the Cholas produced a systematic administration which it have its own features. The Cholas had excellent system of administration. King was at the apex of administration. The inscriptions referred him as Perumal Adigal, the great one, or Ko, the king. The cult of God King received due recognition and importance, built temples over the remains of deceased kings. The king was assisted a council of ministers called Udan Kuttam. Rajaguru, the priest of the royal family, played very important part in the administration. They have elaborate administrative machinery. The officers of the period were paid by land assignments and honored with titles. The empire, for the administrative convenience, divided into Mandalam, Valanadu, Nadu, village. There was a system of autonomous administration for towns known as Nagaram under the Council Nagarathar. Existence of Sabha and assemblies are the special features in Chola polity. There was an autonomy in village administration and also in provincial administration. There were three types of village assemblies. One is Oor. It is an assembly which includes all the classes of people who had and holding in the village or the tax paying residents of the villages. Sabha is another assembly. It exclusively a Brahmin assembly and existed only in the Agrahara or Chaturvedi Mangalam of villages. Nagaram is another assembly. It is an assembly of traders and merchants found more commonly in trade sectors. They catered the needs of the mercantile interests. These assemblies were assisted by committees having jurisdiction over several spheres of activities. To know about the particulars of the village assemblies and local self-government in Chola period, the Uttar Meruru inscriptions issued by the Chola monarch Paratka the First are the main source of information to reconstruct the village administration of the period. The inscriptions furnish detailed information regarding the nature of the composition of committees, qualification of the candidate for the membership, and the procedure adopted to appoint the members of these committees. The Uttar Meruru inscription mentions the qualifications to become member in the village assembly. They are ownership of more than 1/4 of veli of land, residence in a house built on one site, age between 35 and 70, knowledge of Vedic literature. These are the required qualifications to become a member in assembly. The same inscriptions also mention the disqualifications. These are the disqualifications of the candidate, those who had been any of the committees for the past 3 years, those who had been on the committees but had failed to submit the accounts together with their respective relatives, those who had committed caste and other great sins as well as their relatives, those who had stolen the property of others. They are the disqualified persons to become a member in the village assembly. The Uttar Meruru inscriptions also furnish the powers of the village assembly. They are empowered to levy taxes and also remission of taxation in exceptional cases, power to confiscate the land of those persons who failed to pay the land tax, settled the local disputes and pronounced the innocence and guilt of the concerned through punishments, in charge of the charitable institutions and temples of the village. Thus, the Cholas have an excellent administrative system at various levels, and it is an important feature of the Chola polity, which became famous as local self-government. Regarding the agrarian structure and fiscal policy of the Cholas, land revenue was the principal source of income. They took sufficient interest in developing agriculture and irrigational facilities. During that time, reclamation of wasteland and the clearing of forests were regularly undertaken. They conducted systematic land survey for the assessment of land tax. The taxes were collected either in kind or cash. Judicial fines were the other potential source of revenue. They had an excellent and trained military. The army consisted of elephants, cavalry, infantry, and navy. The soldiers generally consisted of two types: Kai Kolar, they are the royal troops; Nattu Padai, they are the local defense. Velaikars were the most dependent troops in the royal service. The importance of Velaikars are they are ready to defend the king with their lives. But the Cholas paid much attention to their navy, which it attested several naval expeditions and their success in Sri Lanka, Maldives and Ceylon. So far we highlighted the special features of the Chola polity, which became famous in Indian polity. Now we can shift our discussion to discuss the cultural contribution of the Cholas. The Chola period witnessed changes in society, economy, learning, art, architecture, painting, and further diffusion of Dravidian culture to Southeast Asia. Regarding the social life is concerned, the caste system was widely prevalent. There was a division of society into Brahmins and non-Brahmins. Little mention of Kshatriyas and Vaishyas in the literature of the period, but the Velalas equated with the Sudras. There was a further social division among non-Brahmins and the non-Velala groups. But however, there was a cooperation among various castes and sub-castes in social and religious life. Institution of slavery was in vogue during the Chola period. System of sati was prevalent. The devadasis and courtesans honored in the society. Regarding the economic life, agriculture and industry flourished. Kanchipuram was the great center of silk weaving. Metal works were developed, owing to great demand of images for temples. This period witnessed remarkable development of both internal and external trade. They conducted extensive maritime and commercial activity with Southeast Asia. Due to the increase of commercial and trade activities, the Cholas issued gold, silver, and copper coins in plenty at various denominations. See the Cholas and their territorial limits, trade routes between Chola Empire, Sri Lanka, and the Southeast Asian countries. The Cholas maintained religious tolerance and they were the builders of several temples in South India. Shaivism and Vaishnavism continued to flourish. Ramanuja, the propagator of Vishishtadvaita, belonged to the period. Several educational institutions attached to the temple. Rajendra Chola I established a college at Ennayiram, there was a growth in Tamil classics. Several scholars flourished in the courts of Chola kings, and they produced masterpieces in Tamil literature. The temple became an important institution and a center of the socio-economic life. Magnificent temples were built at Chidambaram, Sridangam, Madurai, Tanjavur, and Gangaikonda Cholapuram. Burudheswara temple, Tanjavur, and Gangaikonda Cholapuram are the important temples, and they were museum specimens to study the Chola art, architecture, sculpture, and painting. With the large scale construction of several temples under the Cholas, the Dravidian style of architecture reached the pinnacle of glory. The chief feature of the Chola temples is the Vimana. They are found at Tanjavur, at Gangaikonda Cholapuram, and several other temples. The Chola temples erected in the later phase are decorated with figures and sculptures. The Chola temples erected in a later phase are decorated with figure sculptures. These Chola sculptors took particular interest in exhibiting their mastery over the art of carving sculptures on the exterior walls of the temples, pillars, door jambs, and ceilings. Besides sculpture, the bronze images of Shiva in respect of Nataraja produced during this period have neither equals nor rivals in the world. They produced different styles of Nataraja images. During this period, the Chola rulers also patronized the art of painting. The traces of Chola paintings are found in the Brihadeeswara temple at Tanjavur. Dear students, with the discussion on Chola history and culture, I hope you may understand the importance of the Cholas and their contribution to Indian culture. Thank you.